Everybody, welcome to Chinese Pod. I'm Joy.
Hi everyone, I'm Josh. 欢迎回到中文播客。
Today we're going to talk about ducks. Ooh, I know a duck. 北京烤鸭, that's the famous Beijing barbecue duck.
北京烤鸭真的很好吃。
But what do ducks actually mean in Chinese culture?
除了北京烤鸭，鸭子也代表爱情。
Oh?
因为鸭子都成双成对。
So that means they come in pairs. Oh, so it represents love. What else do ducks represent?
鸭子也代表自由，因为鸭子都自由自在的在水里游泳。
Okay, so I guess free as a bird, free as a duck, that applies. Oh, and I also know the most famous duck, which is not the Beijing duck. It is the Disney Donald Duck.
唐老鸭。
Hey, that's an awesome name. Hope you got that trademarked.
Well, I tried, but it got refused.
And did you fight it? Man, you can't put all this money into your brand without knowing that your brand is protected.
Well, the trademark office refused it. So what can I do?
Actually, you can do a lot about this. The attorneys at trademarkers.com are dealing with refusals all the time.And in many cases, can salvage your trademark by adding disclaimers or arguing against objections from the trademark office. And did you know that if there are other earlier trademarks that pose an obstacle to your registration, there are ways to require them to actually prove actual use and have them cancelled if they are not being used? Just contact the professionals at trademarkers.com.With a network of attorneys in more than 60 countries, we make sure your brand is protected. Trademarkers.com
唐老鸭, that's right. Okay, so today we're going to talk about some idioms that have the word duck in them. Let's check it out.
我们来看看第一个谚语。死鸭子嘴硬。所以鸭子的嘴本来就是硬的。就算到死了,鸭子的嘴还是硬的。所以你觉得这什么意思?
Oh, so I know this term 嘴硬. When you say somebody 嘴硬, their mouth is really hard, it basically means they're very stubborn. And I guess if that duck's mouth is still hard even though he's dead, he's like stubborn till the end.
有坚持到底的意思。也表示一个人很固执。也就是大家都觉得他是错的,他却不承认自己是错的。这时候你就可以说他死鸭子嘴硬。
Oh, I feel like I know a few people like that. Let's make a sentence about them.
比如说有一个人,他就是说谎,或是他不承认自己的错。你就可以说他这个人死鸭子嘴硬,你别浪费口水跟他吵了。
Don't waste your breath. Don't argue with him. He's never gonna admit it.
我有一个例子。上次去一间水饺店。水饺店的老板娘给我算错了钱，但是她却不承认。这时候你就可以骂她，你不要死鸭子嘴硬了，说谎了还不承认。
So did you get the money back in the end?
到最后还叫警察来呢。
Oh no, it's too stubborn.
我们来看看第二个谚语，赶鸭子上架。赶鸭子上架，你觉得是什么意思？
Gan is to rush, right? So we're forcing the duck to... Well, the verb 上架 means to be displayed or launched. But I don't think that makes sense. Why are we launching the duck?
上架常常听到是会放在一些比如说东西上架了或是商品上架了。这边的这个架的意思是高处的意思。
Oh, a high place. So how is that related to the duck?
因为鸭子不喜欢高处，鸭子喜欢待在水边。
So it's very dangerous. Okay, I know. So we're forcing the duck to a place that he doesn't want to go or he's not ready to go.
没错，所以意思是强人所难，强迫人去做能力不及的事情。
Okay, so if somebody's not ready, we can also say, 别赶鸭子上架。
对，你可以说，别赶鸭子上架了。很明显的他还没准备好, 我们找别人来吧。
Okay, so let's not force him to do what he doesn't want to do. He's not ready, so we'll find somebody else.
所以我们刚刚说到强人所难，这个句子和赶鸭子上架是一样的意思。比如说刚刚说别赶鸭子上架，我们可以换成别强人所难了，他还没准备好，我们找别人吧。
Okay, so 强人所难 is...勉强 is to force. So let's not force somebody to a difficult situation. So we're not going to force them because they're clearly not ready. Oh, I can think of a situation where we can apply this. When we're opening up a store or starting a business, we need to take care of the safety precautions.
没错，比如说逃生出入口的设置，或者是灭火器的放置位置都一定要检查。所以开店前千万别赶鸭子上架，安全检查没做好就别营业，免得出人命了。
Oh, 出人命 it could cause a life. That's not going to be good. So it's important not to rush and safety measures need to be taken care of.
我们来看看第三个句子，煮熟的鸭子飞了。所以煮熟的鸭子应该不会飞吧？那你觉得这一句话是什么意思？
Okay, so 煮熟的鸭子 is a cooked duck. But we're saying in the sentence that the cooked duck is flying, which is something that shouldn't happen because it's dead. So I'm guessing it means something like, something that I thought was normal or maybe that I thought was going to happen, something else happened instead?
没错。他用一种比较夸张的方式来形容已经到手的东西搞丢了。
So we're talking about a situation where you almost get something, but then you lost it. Like, for example, a job?
比如说找工作的时候一定有很多轮的面试。
Several rounds?
所以你可以说他以为这个工作是他的，因为他非常的有把握。但是在最后一轮面试的时候他没通过。所以让煮熟的鸭子飞了。
So would you say it's kind of his own fault? Does the sentence have that kind of meaning?
有可能。
Hello friends, this is Sarah Chung, a content creator for ChinesePod. Each week we find new topics relevant to you and send them to your mobile device. Currently we have over 4,000 lessons on the app covering a variety of topics. A huge thank you to all of our subscribers who make this amazing journey possible for all. If you are not a subscriber and you would like to try us out with no obligation, go to ChinesePod.com and start your free 30-day trial. You have nothing to lose and so much to gain, so sign up now.
可能是自己在面试的时候说错了话，或是别人太厉害了，抢走了这个工作机会，让煮熟的鸭子飞了。
How about another situation like when you're playing sports and you have a winning streak, but then maybe at the final game, they lost?
这时候就是轻敌。
What does that mean?
轻敌的意思就是看清对手。所以刚刚说了，打篮球好了。篮球队原本可以赢这个比赛，却因为轻敌，所以让煮熟的鸭子飞了。
So they had a winning streak and maybe they were too proud, so they didn't assume that their enemies or competitors were actually quite good, and then they lost that last game. Okay, so we talked about ducks today and human relationships and especially work relationships. For our summary, I'm going to give Josh a challenge. Can you put all three of these idioms that we learned in a scenario all together into one story?
当然可以。
Okay.
上次这个案子一直都谈得很顺利，结果爱钱的老板到最后还想拿到更多利润。
Okay, so there was a case and everything was going very well. But then the boss was greedy and he wanted to get just a bit more profit from the negotiation. And then what happened?
他给客户开了很高的价钱，还强迫别人与我们继续合作。
Oh, so he set up a really high price and forced the other party to continue to work with us.
就是这样赶鸭子上架，让煮熟的鸭子飞了。
Oh, so I'm guessing that he lost this case in the end because the price was too high and the other party wasn't ready.
是啊，他还死鸭子嘴硬，一直说是客户没有远见，却不承认自己很贪心。
Ah, okay. So he lost that case because he was forcing someone else to do something that they weren't ready to do and making that price too high. Okay, so basically this teaches us don't be too greedy and don't be too rushed. We want to take things step by step and be observant. All right, hopefully you've enjoyed this episode about ducks. If you know any more Chinese idioms with the word 鸭 or 鸭子, in it, please leave them down in the comments below. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm Joy.
I'm Josh.
See you next time.
下次见。
Bye-bye.
As usual, ChinesePod provides an extensive selection of learning materials for this lesson on its website, www.chinesepod.com. You can access this lesson directly with the lesson number 4300. So just go to www.chinesepod.com/4300 and you will find a transcript, vocabulary, and much more. The link again, www.chinesepod.com/4300.